Winter is here in the Waterloo region, so does that mean that the buying season is done? Just a reminder that if you like this video, I'd really appreciate you giving me a thumbs up. Comment down below with things you like, other questions that you have, anything like that. And subscribe if you want to see more stuff like this. I try to upload a video every week. Winter is here. Does that mean that the buying season is over? In my opinion, not at all. On the contrary, this is the perfect time to start thinking about buying. Now, this week, I only want to talk about buying. If you are buying and selling, you may be fitting into a different timeline depending on your market. But if you are just looking to buy right now, the winter is the best time to do that. In fact, I would say that January is the best month of the entire year if you're just looking to buy. Come January, it's cold outside, folks don't want to go out and trudge through the snow, people have just spent a lot of money on the holidays, maybe they just got back from a trip or exchanging gifts, kids are back in school, everybody's looking forward to the spring. So for first-time buyers or someone who's just looking to get an investment property, this is the best time to start scouring the market. In January, if we only have a quarter or a third of the number of buyers we'd have in the spring, that's gonna be a lot easier for you to get into a property, not having it fly off the market, and it'll give you more room for negotiation. A six-year study was done that showed that buying a home in the GTA in January would, on average, save buyers $43,000. And really, for a buyer, that just comes down to planning. That comes down to you not spending all of your money around the holidays. That comes for you planning to go out in the winter on those days when it may be dark outside, you're going to look at a property, but you know what? It can pay off. And not only does that $43,000 mean that these people are just saving cash, but it's also very likely that these people were able to sneak conditions into their offers that they may not have been able to do in the spring. You also have to take into consideration that although demand is low and that's giving you a lot of power, supply is also low in those situations. Sellers know that January is not the greatest time for them to list. Sellers often wait until May or June to start thinking about listing their property. Now, for a buyer, that means that you may not have the same selection that you would if you wait until June or July. My experience with first-time buyers, especially in the market that we're in right now, where it just ends up being a battle to try to get into it, is that waiting to have 100 options in June isn't usually as necessary or as valued by those first-time buyers. Being able to look at maybe 30 properties in January is going to give them a much better chance of getting into the market, even if it means taking on a few extra projects when they get the keys. So there you have it. Now, we're mid-November right now, which puts it as a perfect time to be talking to a lender, getting your finances in order, maybe working on some of those handy skills that you can bring to a potential property come late December, January, early February, when the competition in the market isn't so hot. That's my take on that. Thank you guys so much for tuning in again this week. Really appreciate it. I will see you next time.